back to my kitchen. Today we're gonna do a pasta and an imitation cheese sauce. I've got the recipe from Gaz Oakley and we're going to give it a try today. We have some chickpea fazuli. I have some nutritional yeast, some raw cashews, some unsweetened soy milk, some chopped ready-to-use garlic, some grainy mustard, and some coconut milk. Okay, so I'm going to do the chickpea fazuli in the Instapot. So when you're doing pasta in the Instapot, you want to do it just about a minute under what you would normally cook it. And the reason I like to cook my pasta in the Instapot as well as the fact that it's chickpea pasta, it's a little bit more delicate and I don't like it to be a rolling boil and be stirring it all the time. So this helps to keep it a little bit together. So I'm just gonna add a big pile of water. I want to make sure there's a lot of water. Then I'm just going to pop my top on, put it to sealed, and then I'm going to pressure cook it for 20 minutes. Oh. So the instructions are 5 to 6 minutes. I'm going to do it for 4 minutes. And then we can move on to our sauce. My recipe is over here. We are doing a Gaz Oakley recipe today. It's called plain mac and cheese, and he's got lots of different variations on there. We might dabble in some of those another day. So for the sauce, I am going to put a whole can of coconut milk. Oh my god! Oh, that was just wrong. That's so many levels. Sorry, you do know how I like to whack my spatula. Alright, so we've got some coconut milk in there. I'm gonna put a cup of the soy milk. And the recipe asks for a cup and a third, but I'm gonna cut a hole back and I can always add, but I can't take away. Then we're gonna add some thyme, which was not in my ingredients before. Bit of a sprinkle. Then I've got some of my garlic. And we do like garlic. The recipe asks for 2 cloves of garlic. I can't see my recipe anymore. I have about a tablespoon of mustard, and it asks for just plain mustard, but I don't have plain mustard. I have this big lumpy mustard that's going in the blender anyway. Then we want a half cup of nuts. Gaz uses almonds in his. I'm going to use cashews because that's what I have. tablespoons of nutritional yeast. I love the smell of nutritional yeast. Yeah, like I have one. I don't have a knuckle technique. So we're just waiting for this to come up to pressure, and then it will cook for 5 minutes, and then we can put it together. I'm adding some more nutritional yeast and some more garlic and a squirt of pepper and a couple of grinds of salt. I found that the coconut milk is making it a bit sweet. So we'll pop that in there. Give it another blend. Oh, I smell the pepper now. Now I will single dip. See if that's butter. It's still quite sweet. I just want to add some umami to it, so I'm going to give it a squirt of lemon, and I'm going to add some miso paste, a big chunk of miso paste, because A, my family really likes it, and B, I think it's going to solve my issue here. As is, it would be fabulous pasta, but doesn't have that flavor I'm looking for. Have another try. Way better. Still has that underlying sweet. Liquid smoke. It was missing liquid smoke. And I think it might satisfy your cheese craving. You can always add some fake cheese, shredded cheese into it if you like. Did you get pictures of that?
Sort of.
Right. So because I don't have to stir it, it's less likely to get all broken up. What?
She's pretty
So I'll cancel that and I will put it on a low saute. What do I want to put in there for oil? So I'm just gonna put a glug of olive oil down. Like, more not a glug, but a drizzle. If you don't want to use oil, that is perfectly fine. I just want to kind of cook my onions out a little bit. Don't want to lose any. And this will come up to speed pretty quickly. Just wait for them to get a bit of a sizzle. And our sauce is ready to go in. Our pasta is drained and ready to be mac and cheese-ish. I had two children. One was of the school of mushy mac and cheese, and the other one liked it baked with the crispy bread on top. So to save time and dishes, typically the mushy cheese guy got his way. But you could take this recipe and put it in a casserole dish and cover it in panko, maybe some seasoning, little oregano, throw it in the oven and bake it till it's nice and crisp and bubbly. That'd also be good. But we're not doing that today because the mushy kid is here. I'm so happy I put that smoke in here. So another thing that you could do with this dish is add some steamed broccoli. That would be very tasty. If you check out Gaz's site, one of the other things that he does with it is freeze it into balls and bread it and deep fry it, which is always good, anything deep fried, right? And he adds a squash and tomato base, which just cranks it up another level. So I'm fairly happy with the way that these have sweated down just a little bit, and I'm going to continue cooking with my, don't want that one, I want this one. I really don't want to leave any of it in there at all. So I would serve this with a big bunch of black pepper, freshly ground black pepper. I think maybe I should start having something to eat before we do these. So I'm just gonna give the onions a mix and let that come up to a bit of a bubble. This makes a lovely less noise than that other machine. I'm excited about trying it with another mustard as well. But there's a company, a local company, that does a beer mustard, and their mustard seeds pop in your mouth, and they call them mustard caviar. And it's so good. It's the best mustard. It's the only time I've ever spent $50 on mustard. When I found these guys. Alrighty. That looks good to me. We'll add our pasta. That's not a mushy sound. So there is what it looks like. And there you have it.
Mushy of what?
Mushy mac and cheese.
We're gonna need a better outro than that.
And there we have some lovely macaroni and cheese that I hope it satisfies your need for cheese and satisfies a craving for you. I'm gonna just try a bite. I'm really glad we put that smoke in there. That is good. Excellent. Let's have dinner.